Just yesterday, I received a message on WhatsApp from Jeremy Silver. He's the chair of the board for the CCDA, the City Center Development Agency, and he sent me a press release along with a photo, and he just said, you know, can you post this? And I read the contents of it. I didn't notice that there was a full release date at the top that said Monday, May 10th. Posted it right away. It turns out that some of the stakeholders downtown, specifically Shyla Sharps, who's been very vocal about her questions of what the CCDA does and their operations, Shyla was very interested to see that they were hiring somebody, just less than a week before they're doing this referendum on possibly disbanding the CCDA. So, I thought I would read to you the update here. And then I'll share with you the phone call that I had with Shyla where she describes her concerns. So here's the memo. The CCDA's Board of Directors is pleased to announce new operations manager, Trish Richard. Trish is a skilled project manager and proven leader with extensive experience in organizations such as No Stone Left Alone and the Community Foundation of Southeastern Alberta. In partnership with Downtown's Positive Life Concepts, Trish was introduced to her new role earlier this month. Lifetime Hatters, Trish and her husband, are ardent supporters of Medicine Hat's historic downtown and are excited to see its business community thrive. The hiring of new operations manager has now allowed the CCDA to restructure and reprioritize. Advocacy, promotions, and support for downtown businesses will remain the core mandates, with Trish's passion and skill set driving increased communication, collaboration, and transparency. We're looking forward to all that we can accomplish together. With the upcoming vote to keep the CCDA an active part of downtown, Trish joins the organization at a crucial time and will be working to shape a new future with the help of downtown stakeholders. The CCDA would like to thank our former leadership for their service and the downtown business community for their ongoing support. The CCDA manages Downtown Medicine Hat's business improvement area and offers advocacy, promotions, and support for all downtown businesses. So, Shyla Sharp, read that. She had something to say. Let's talk. You've been a business owner in the downtown for over a decade now.
2005?
Yeah. You've
my first rodeo.
Yeah, and you've had some past contentions and, well, maybe not even, let's not even qualify any of the contentions. You've had questions about the operations at the CCDA for a long time.
That would be correct.
And so recently, just today, they dropped this press release. Jeremy Silver sent it over to me on WhatsApp, just the photo and the release there. And he said, hey, you know, if you could post this. And so I read it and I looked and I thought, okay, yeah, I'll post it. It seems to me maybe there'll be somebody who's interested in talking about this. And it's like less than an hour later and you've contacted me already. So Shyla, tell me what you think about this.
I think it is just a very clear indication of the lack of management and leadership. If 70% of your members 3 months ago signed a petition asking for a referendum at City Hall, so whether they vote against or vote for, it's really not the point right now. All they're saying is we want this to be on the table. We want to talk about it. But majority of people were like, let's get rid of these guys. This isn't working. It's not, you know, the progress, it's not the future. So, no, I understand feelings are hurt, but this isn't about their feelings. So, and it's not about them as individuals, or it's just not personal. This is business. So, as you know, I was one of those people that got that petition going, and we got the numbers, we put it in front of city council, the city clerk, and, you know, made sure that, you know, it was all kosher, and referendum is granted. Now we go to vote this coming week. May 11th and 13th, I believe the dates are, where again the business owners have to go into City Hall. We have to again vote yes or no that we want to disband. So the vote is to disband the CCDA, not to keep it active, which are two very different things. So the email is misleading. Anyways, that's what it was. So your membership has spoken that they want to talk about this. Your membership didn't say, please spend more money, please recruit, use an outside agency to recruit, and hey, and then when we disband in 3 months, or if we disband, we can talk about severance. Because that's the best thing to do, right?
Right. Well, I mean, it says here in the media release that Trish is a skilled project manager and a proven leader with extensive experience in organizations. So, I mean, what if she could just turn the whole thing around now? Like, isn't that a possibility, Shyla?
Oh, absolutely it is. And I think that is, this isn't about Trish. I don't know her. I'm sure she's lovely and I'm sure she's fantastic. And that is still not the point. The point is, we as members want to disband the CCDA. The petition we put forth was to disband, not to rehire. So this was not about, oh, it's the wrong people, oh, it's just games. They keep trying to hire people, and it's not what we want. So listen to us. They keep, you know, when I put in this petition, and if you go to the CCDA Facebook page, there's a clear... We just want to listen to the membership. Well, like, do you want it in, you know, phonetically written out for you? Because obviously you're not listening. And how do we hire someone less than 1 week before we go to vote?
Less than 1 week?
We go to vote next week. Today's the what, the 7th?
Do you think that gives ample time for the business owners to get an introduction to this new hire and make their decision based on that?
It was, you know what, it's a ploy, as far as I'm concerned, and here we go again, right? So, and that's my, no, here's the thing, none of us are interested. This is not about her. They don't have the right idea of what we want, and they're not hearing it. We don't need yet another board by city council. At the end of the day, the breadcrumbs still go back to the city, right?
Mm-hmm.
So the city, this is a CCDA, is a city-driven board.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so we're mandated when we live in that area. So here we are, we're there, your board, your membership has spoken, asked for a referendum. Let's just go status quo until that happens. Now, if the vote happens on next Tuesday or Wednesday, and you know what, everybody votes yes, then guess what? Then we hire someone. And we move on. And then people like Shyla decide if they stay downtown or if they switch their property to residential, and then I never have to pay it again. There's lots of options. I can move it to Calgary. I have options. But why would you do this at this point? Other than, to me, it's a blatant screw you. We don't care what your vote is. We're going to do what we want to do 5 days before the vote. It's infuriating.
I see that they qualified their statement here with Trish's passion for transparency was one of the things that she's passionate about. And I wondered if you could speak to just the general idea of the CCDA and your history speaking to its transparency.
Sure. Well, first of all, again, I won't say anything about Trish because I don't know her.
Yeah, no, I just, I totally agree. I'm not trying to put her on the on the gallows or anything.
Yeah.
It just references that in this statement that Trish has a passion for transparency, and I wondered sort of why you think they would want to reflect that to you.
Well, I think they want to reflect it to everybody because that's one of their complaints is that it isn't transparent, and I think they really want to do it because. Well, they just hired somebody that wasn't, and the whole process wasn't transparent. Why, as a downtown stakeholder, was I just informed they had a hiring process, and they didn't use or tell any of us stakeholders, or if they did, it selectively went out again, which is kind of status quo. And then they used a downtown agency, which is my second question that I've had. I have sent a message over to Jeremy Silver prior, as soon as I got this, saying, what the hell? So number one, we had a recruiting process that wasn't told to the stakeholders, so I don't know who applied. Number two, you used a downtown agency. Well, guess who else is a downtown agency that wasn't asked to compete on this bid?
You.
So, right. So again, let's talk transparency, shall we?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I guess it's one thing when you don't really know what's going on downtown and you're a business owner and you never even heard that happened, but it seems like an entirely different thing when you're a business owner that would want to compete for these things and they're supposed to be supporting you and you weren't told about this?
Well, Right. So, and you nailed it. But here's what would have happened if they would have came to me as a downtown business owner that happens to do this for a living and said, Shyla, would you like to bid on this postment or this recruitment? We would like you to do this. And I would have said, I would love to. After the vote, you have some ethical responsibility to let this vote happen before you hire someone, both to your stakeholders and to the individual that we're hiring.
And what's the one ask that Shyla would give to Tom?
What the heck are you thinking? Can we stop doing stupid things? Here it is, where your membership is asking for this. I feel like I'm reiterating I'm on a broken record right now.
Yeah, this is deja vu all over again for me as well. It's like...
Like, how many times do we have to do this?
And yeah, we've done it in person, we've done it social distancing, we've done it on the phone, we've covered this one, haven't we?
Right. And here's further to that, we're going through yet another round of restrictions, but hey, we're going to keep spending your money, because we think that's a super good idea. Super good.
Anything else I should ask you about? Any other thing you want to say about this media release today?
Can I ask what time you got the media release?
About an hour ago. I mean, I got it from Jeremy, and then I posted it, and then you called me. I mean, it was a pretty quick chain of events.
Yeah. Well, I didn't see... My email came from CCDA at 3:04. So I've been flipping through to see if there was any emails on the recruiting, and there was none. So,
yeah.
At the end of the day, if Jeremy wants to have a conversation, me, him, and you, that's fine. We can do it on air. I am so unimpressed. I make sure it's on my Facebook feed. I want everybody to vote, and whether it's yes or no, they need to vote. Hey, at the end of the day, if it gets voted yes, Shyla decides what she wants to do with her business like the rest of us that voted no. And it won't be downtown, and that's fine, right?
Mm-hmm.
And that's on me and my decisions. I will not support the CCDA. I will not. I cannot. This kind of incompetence is just unbelievable. Okay, I'm done.
I'll do my best to talk to Jeremy, see if I can at very least interview him, and if possible, I think that's a great idea for me to possibly moderate a conversation between you two so that we could find out more about why and what the plan is here. So I'll give him a call right away.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thanks.
You bet. Take care.
Have a good one, Shyla. Bye-bye.
You too, Tom. Bye.
After speaking with Shyla Sharps, I tried to contact somebody from the CCDA. Jeremy Silver did not make himself available for comment. He's the chair of the board, and instead said that I could interview the new operations manager, Trish Richard, and she would only be available on Monday, which is basically one day before the early referendum voting and only 3 days before the actual referendum vote. So, they basically could not be reached for comment in time for this story to be presented, but I will follow up with them, and I will have an interview with Trish on Monday and get her reaction to the concerns of one of the stakeholders. If you like any of the content that I create, maybe this movie, maybe other videos, maybe something that I posted, please support me by supporting my sponsors. I'd like to mention Patty at Hemp Town Rock. She's in the beautiful downtown of Medicine Hat, and that's under the purview of the CCDA, so she's been dealing with them for a long time. But the other thing she's been dealing with a long time are bongs, pipes, vaporizers, magic bubble machines. Have you heard of that before? Magic butter machine. Yeah, that's what it's called. What I call it, bubble. You can make your own edibles. It's totally possible. It's easy to do. Patty has all of the cannabis advice that you could need. See her in downtown Medicine Hat at Hemp Town Rock. And, maybe if you get a little bit indulgent on the cannabis side of things, then maybe what you're going to want to do next is get yourself a chicken sandwich at Baba Cluck. It's up in Red Cliff. It's right next to the Co-op Gaspar. They're attached. You can go on their website and you can make an order. My recommendation right now is the boob witch sandwich. You build it yourself on their website. Super easy to do. You go up there, pick it up, and I think they also have patio set up now, so you're allowed to eat outdoors as long as those restrictions haven't changed. They have a beautiful patio where you can hang out, or you can, of course, take that meal home and eat it at your own place, because this is comfort food and it should make you feel like you're at home. So check out Baba Cluck and get that boob witch sandwich. Thanks for watching, folks.